Hello out there. So, get out those hankies because it's about to get emotional with Tchaikovsky's sixth and final symphony called the Pathetique, which means with great feeling. I think it will become evident why that title was chosen. We're going to listen to a little bit of the second theme of the first movement, and then the end and the beginning of movements three and four, which I think you'll find is very much the opposite of how Beethoven chose to do that. So, drop the needle here. So here's the secondary theme of the opening movement. The symphony itself is in B minor, and following classical tradition, the secondary theme is in the relative major D, which means it shares a key signature with B minor. It shows Tchaikovsky's real gift for melody. And his ability to even take a major theme and make it sound kind of sad. There's a haunting beauty to it. So by this point, the symphony had been rapidly developing since Beethoven. Now, this is to the point where even sections of a movement have sections unto themselves. So this is the secondary theme, and within that secondary theme, this symphony has kind of an ABA type format. So this is the B section within the secondary, and it kept going on and on from there. This recording is by the Philadelphia Orchestra with their famous conductor Eugene Ormandy. If you can find Philadelphia Orchestra stuff with Ormandy, it's really great and a unique sound. Here's this melody. With some texture added. Now, what gives it kind of this melancholy quality? Two things. One is the contour. Ooh. Little jolt there. Tchaikovsky's even major melodies tend to kind of trend down, where they start high and they just kind of go downward, 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 which can kind of give kind of a. Right here. It's just falling, maybe a little rise, and then down. Secondly, using some extended harmony, and what I mean by that is. Most chords have three notes in them, called a triad, and sometimes there's sevenths, which is four notes, but some of these chords have five notes of them, which kind of adds extra dissonance to it. And then also using some notes outside of the key. So this is D major, and he throws in a really dissonant chord. It's a D diminished chord, which has two tritones. And a tritone is like the devil's interval, where it sounds really dissonant. And the diminished chord has two tritones stacked on top of each other for like extra dissonance and really generates a lot of feeling. So we're rounding out the end of this section with some seriously quiet clarinet. To the dynamic range that Beethoven kept pushing, this section ends with six P's. Pianissimo. You can tell from the very first chord that this is not going to be a happy ending. Second theme. It's a another one of these major themes that's just in his hands is just so moving. Take the melody out and play it by itself. It sounds kind of silly and kind of sing-songy, but with the treatment, it really adds something. What helps it along is the use of suspensions. And suspensions, what that means is there's some notes in chords that kind of linger past, so they make a dissonance before they become part of the next chord. When I hear this particular part, it's a real almost sense of nostalgia. Something that maybe you once had or maybe never had, and you can't have it back again. The memory is there, but the person or the thing is not. And the piece continues from there. It gets, there's kind of a panic-inducing, section of music that follows here, and then complete resignation. So I think what helps when we're feeling anxious or depressed is to know that we're not alone. And I think that's the message to be gleaned from this incredible piece of music, Tchaikovsky talking to us and telling us we're not alone and things will be okay. So I encourage you, listen to this entire piece of music. It's fantastic. And thank you so much for watching.